What would I consider romantic? For example, the episode of Jacksonville in season 2. The ending, I really thought Olivia and Peter were going to kiss. I thought they really had something in common. I was really surprised towards the ending when Peter and Olivia were over there and they actually did kiss. In season 3, when Olivia was, you know, in our universe, and she was like really hitting on Peter. What would I consider scary? Well, I don't get scared that often. The episode of Neither Here Nor There. When Olivia and Lincoln Lee first met again, I think Olivia, you know, could have been a bit more nicer to Lincoln Lee. In season 4, the episode of Back to Where You've Never Been, it was pretty interesting. Seeing Peter and, you know, Blue Link go over to the Red Universe, I thought it was even more shocking when Blue Lincoln Lee and Red Lincoln Lee, you know, when they came together. You know, if the show was real, if you could travel to another time, I think I probably would have wanted to take the chance, you know, just to see what it was like. Two, the episode of It's a New Day in an Old Town. It really scared me when I saw Olivia come crashing out of that car. She, you know, hits her head. I'll never forget that episode because this very same night that episode was made, I was also in the hospital, you know, close to dying, for example. I'd like to ask her why she didn't fall for Peter, you know, from the very beginning. I mean, I know at first she was in love with that jerk off, John Scott. I know Olivia was at first in love with him, but I didn't like him. He was a jerk. I really think that Olivia, you know, belongs with Peter. Well, I'd like to ask Olivia is why? Why didn't she want to be involved with Lincoln Lee? I mean, the Lincoln Lee from over there. I mean, at first it seemed like they were more than friends, but I guess it wasn't meant to be. Towards the ending, when Olivia, you know, really ended up with Blue Lincoln Lee, I thought it was pretty interesting. I mean, funny the way he acted around her. Well, I'd like to ask Walter, or should I say John Noble, is why? Why did he take the risk in the first place of, you know, going over there into the red universe? Well, like the observers said, just sort of threw things off balance. What would I like to ask Peter Bishop, or should I say Joshua Jackson? Well, in season 3, the episode of The Day We Died, I'd like to know why on earth did he even get into that machine? And then when he comes back, everybody's memories just vanish. Like they didn't even know he even existed. I mean, I wasn't, you know, too happy about that at all.
And it is worse than anything you could possibly imagine. This is not a war that can be won. If one side dies, we all die. Maybe it's time we start to fix it.
I thought it was even more intense when Peter goes to see his mother. And she sees him, it was like she was looking at a ghost or something. But I wasn't too happy when Red Lincoln Lee Hill was killed. I think they could have ended that episode, you know, a different way. Olivia, she is really something else. Like when she traveled to the blue universe and pretended to be Olivia, then she goes home to her universe and I mean, it's like she was trying to be good and trying to be bad at the same time. Season 1 of Fringe, you know, it was okay. I mean, you know, it started off good, but I think it got even better when Season 2 came along. Lincoln Lee, Blue Link. He seems to be a bit shy at times, but I think he is a really cool, cute actor. Red Lincoln Lee? Boy, he is a toughie. Sometimes he acts like a smart aleck. But I still like him too.
Really? This is Agent Lee. I understand somebody there reported my show be lost.
Agent Lee?
Charlie Francis. Well, Blue Charlie Francis, I really miss him. I mean, he seemed like such a nice guy.
Towers lost contact 3 hours in. You thought it might have been electrical.
What happens now?
We're all gonna kill it.
Still good FBI agents. Red, Charlie Francis. Ooh, I thought he was totally hot. Totally different than blue Charlie Francis. I don't know how to explain it, but red Charlie Francis, oh, he just turned me on inside here.
I'm afraid it's just gonna... Sorry to bother you, Mrs. Dunham. Just, wondering if you heard from Olivia. So that's... What if she's telling the truth? What if it's not the real her? That is not...
Alternate, I never really did like him. Because of the way he treated Olivia and Olivia. I guess, you know, everyone deserves a second chance.
What if a new identity doesn't know? It should no longer be necessary. You wanted to see me, sir?
25 years ago, you couldn't have made this decision.
Jessica, Nicole, in the blue universe, who Astrid? Farnsworth, well, she pretty much just takes care of Walter, which, you know, is interesting. I mean, I love them all. They're all great characters. She's a really, really nice young lady. Red Astrid Farnsworth. She seems to be a bit shy, but she's.
Welcome, Agent.
Season 5. I don't even know what to say about that season. I mean, it's like. Like, it just wasn't Fringe. I mean, there wasn't much excitement going on. It was more kind of like a sad love story, sort of. At the ending of season 5, you know, last episode, it's, you know, it ended kind of good, but kind of sad, too.
The rest of my life.
Yeah,
it's
kind of
sad.
Yeah,
it's
I still didn't like it, because, well, for one, the Red Universe wasn't involved, and, you know, I really like the Red Universe. It's more exciting when when the characters from over there are involved. In season 5, I have to say I really, really missed Lincoln Lee. I mean, it just wasn't the same without him. But, you know, at the ending of season 5, you know, last episode, it's, you know, it ended kind of good, but kind of sad, too. Well, anyway, Fringe is the best show ever. And I'll never stop watching it. I pretty much watch it 2-3 times a day. I guess you could say I'm sort of, like, Fringe-obsessed. It'd be nice if J.J. Abrams, you know, would make some Fringe movies. I really, really love the show. Once again, good work. Good luck to all you Fringe stars. Love you all very much. Hope to see you again and something else. It, you know, be nice.
Thank you.